a simple blue box, potentially carrying one of the most dangerous pathogens in the world, on its way to be tested. In less than 4 hours, we'll find out whether it contains the Ebola virus. The fate of three patients depends on what's inside. Simply getting the blood samples is a life-threatening job. One of these workers told us he has a 9-month-old baby at home. They'll do everything they can to protect themselves. Three pairs of gloves, booties, and layer after layer of gowns. They go in to see the patients, every single inch of their body covered, impermeable suits, nothing in, nothing out. You see, even a drop of the Ebola virus that gets through a break in your skin can infect you. And we all have breaks in our skin.
This is the painstaking detail and process you have to go through to be able to interact with these patients with Ebola. This is as close as we can get. They're decontaminating themselves, but they've taken the blood samples and put them in this blue ice chest over here, and it's highly suspicious that contains Ebola.
WHO lab technicians suit up next. They've just been hand-delivered the blue boxes. Now it's their job to test the sample for the deadly virus. They're going to have the results just 2 hours from now. But a few years ago, being able to test for Ebola on its own turf was impossible. Precious blood samples had to be taken out of remote forested areas in Central Africa and flown to the CDC in Atlanta or the WHO in Geneva. Pilots would sometimes refuse to fly the dangerous pathogens. And even if they did, it could take days or weeks to get the results. 8 p.m., we get the call.
So two of these are positive.
So two of the three patients now have confirmed Ebola.
Michaela, one of the things I want to point out is very important is that after someone is exposed, it can sometimes take anywhere between 2 to 21 days for them to develop symptoms. You can see the problem there. You get exposure, and then you maybe get on an airplane and travel around the world. It's an unlikely scenario, but again, that's what they're trying to prevent. This has gone viral, so to speak. They're trying to prevent it from going global.
Yeah, they certainly are. One of the things that we're concerned about, obviously, Sanjay, is your safety and the safety of our crew. Given what we don't know about how it's spread, given what we do know about the death rate, 90% death rate, what are you guys doing to protect yourselves?
But it's worth pointing out that Ebola is actually a difficult thing to quote-unquote catch. It's not airborne, for example, like the flu. You have to have prolonged contact with somebody's bodily fluids. And that's why, you know, healthcare workers, family members are most at risk. 14 healthcare workers, for example, have died. But the real key is obviously just, you know, keeping your skin protected if you're in close proximity. You saw the suits that people wear. We are keeping our distance while still being able to report the story, but that's sort of the key. The problem, the bigger challenge is for the people behind me, and they go through that painstaking process, as you saw, just to be able to have any proximity to these patients.